Hello and welcome back to the Payments Professor's Professional Development course on what to do at conferences. And in this series, we're to the point where we're talking about how to talk to people at a conference. You're at the conference, and I've told you about getting the attendee list. I told you about just walking up and saying hi and introducing yourself. That is one of the key things. Now, I know a lot of people say that's not so easy to do. I understand how that can be difficult to do, but do it anyway. One of the key things I tell people when I'm doing speaker coaching, if you want to be a better speaker, you got to overcome the fear of talking to people. When you're speaking, you're just speaking to a large group. When you're at a conference, you're usually talking to one or two people. Walk up and say hi, but I'm afraid. Well, let me tell you something. Think about how that fear feels. Think about how that fear feels. How does fear feel? And then I ask people, how does excitement feel? If you know what it's like when you feel scared and afraid. Well, how do you feel when you're all excited and like this is gonna be fun? I think if you stop and really digest it and feel it for a second, you're gonna see there's no difference between excitement and the feeling of fear. So realize when you're gonna go talk to somebody, I'm not afraid. No, I'm excited. I get to go meet somebody new. I get to go share my experiences with them. More than that, I get to go learn from them. And when you are talking to people, I don't believe there's such thing as small talk. I really don't. Why? Because we're not small people. Be yourself, be big, be huge, be bold. Take a chance to actually get to know somebody. And you want to know one of my key secrets of getting to know people at conferences or anywhere, even in general in life? Be interested instead of being interesting. Wait, what does that mean? Be interested instead of being interesting. Being interested means you want to learn about them. You genuinely want to learn about them. Put the phone away. You don't need it. Will there be a time where we're going to exchange information? You betcha, and we'll get to that. But when you're first talking to somebody, put the phone away and talk to them. Get to know their name, but get to know them. Ask them what it is that they do. That's the number one question I hear at conferences. What do you do? And when they tell you their job title, ask them, well, what do you really do? Ask them, what do you like most about your job? One of my favorite questions too is, what do you like least? What are the problems that you're having? For example, in the banking industry, I'll say, what are the issues that you're having? What are the problems that you're having? What are the solutions you found to those problems? Why are you at this conference? What is it you're wanting to learn? What do you think is the biggest topic out there facing the industry right now? The biggest topic out there facing your organization? The biggest topic out there facing you? And listen to what they say. Sometimes the best thing you can do is repeat it back to them, but be interested in what they've got to say, because you'll be able to learn from it. You'll be able to also make a professional acquaintance, maybe even a friend. I know in the case of Payments Professor, many of my friends do work in this industry because I've been working with them years and getting to know them. And those are the types of questions that I ask them. Why are you here? What are you learning? What do you want to gain? You know, another question I'll ask them too, is there anybody you would like to meet? Why? Because I know a lot of people and I'll be glad to introduce you to them. I also sometimes ask them, hey, do you know so-and-so? Would you mind introducing me to them? Oh, there's a way to be able to get to know some of those people. If you're afraid, you're feeling that fear, that's what you do right there. Talk to somebody else that you do know and ask them, hey, do you know so-and-so? Would you mind introducing me to them? Another way to get over that fear is get you a wingman or a wingwoman, whichever is appropriate. There's a rule that I used to follow, and I still do, that I learned from a very early mentor and employer. And in his particular role, he would say when we were at conferences that no more than two employees should ever be together at one time. Because whenever you have more than two employees together at one time, you've got a meeting. And we can have meetings at work. We're at conferences, and conferences, remember we had to justify the expenses to be there, can be quite expensive. So we want to make sure we're getting the most out of it. Team up with somebody, because alone, yeah, it's a little bit harder, or it can be. But when you've got somebody there, you got a wingman, somebody to support you, somebody to be able to help you, somebody to be able to listen in too. And that's one of the key things. If you're going to be the wingman or wingwoman, you need to listen in too. You may hear things the other person doesn't. And you can get together afterwards and compare notes of what you learned. So get a wingman Remember, just groups of two, otherwise you're having a meeting, and go around and meet people. I told you about meeting the vendors. Go and meet the people too. Another great one to do, another great way to get to know the people at the conference. Again, in the sessions you're in, are the people with the same questions and concerns you have. If somebody asks a question that is really relevant to what you're doing, at the end of that session, tell them, thank you for asking that. I was thinking the same thing, but I didn't get a chance to ask it, and I'm so glad that you did. Or if somebody shares a solution, tell them, you know, your solution, I think it's going to help me, and I'm glad you shared. Would you mind telling me more about it? It's amazing what you can do when you learn to be interested in what people are saying instead of worrying about being interesting. Now, what does being interesting mean? It means you get what I call the opera singer syndrome. Opera singer syndrome is when you sit there and go, me, 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 let me tell you about me, 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 me. Don't do that. I'm telling that to you, Payments Professor, but I'm telling that to the rest of you too, because people don't want to hear about you as much as they'll want to talk about themselves. And I don't mean that in a negative way. Let people talk about themselves and you'll find you have a great conversation going on. That concludes this segment of the professional development series of what to do at a conference. If you got any questions or comments, please put them below. I would love to learn from you. What are the tactics that you use to be able to talk to people? Do you got any questions that you know are just good ones that you'd like to share that can help people be able to make those contacts? And we got another video coming up, and in this final video, what we're gonna do is, well, what do we do after the conversation's over?